Hey friends, this is Amrita. Welcome back to my channel. In my earlier sessions, I have already explained 6 stages of HR life cycle, that is attraction, recruitment, onboarding, development, retention, separation. So then I have also explained and illustrated the evolution of OB, organizational behavior, or the HR, like pre-classical, classical, behavioral, quantitative, modern. So please check my previous session and watch this video. Do like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Now I'm going to start with, as I've mentioned in my earlier session of HR, today it would be all about motivation and leadership. These two factors are very much essential, very much required to run our organization smoothly, and plays a vital role in the role of an HR. Okay? And you need to boost up the morale. That is it all about. So how will you motivate and all? I'm coming to that a bit later. So let me just define what is motivation. It's basically stimulation to accomplish desired result. As I've mentioned, in any organization, it is very important to have the main mission and vision and the goals. So depending on that, the talent pool, the development, the recruitment, everything comes. So first we need to have that vision fixed, or the goal. So depending on that, it's the stimulation. Motivation is just the stimulation to accomplish that goal, mission, or vision. Okay, so motivation can be of two types. Content theories and process theories. Content theories, like includes Maslow's 5 factors: physiological needs, safety, social, self-esteem, self-actualization. That's at the top, and it's kind of pyramid approach. So basic physiological, then comes safety, social, self-esteem, self-actualization. I have also explained this in my last session of HR, where I have described that was included in the behavioral era of HR. So Maslow proposed the term. Well, it has some defects also. So I'm not getting into that. Defects as in, like, the theory says, like, first we have the physiological, then safety, and then social. Like, one-on-one we have to approach, but it might differ. It might differ because one can go to, like, after fulfilling the physiological and safety, one can go to self-esteem or like that, can jump between the steps. So it can happen. So basically the Maslow's 5 factors. So other than that, there is the Herzberg's 2 factors theory. What does that mean? Like, 2 factors he proposed. One is satisfaction and the other one is no satisfaction. Satisfaction, from where do satisfaction comes? Like recognition, achievement, pay, these are directly involved for satisfaction. And what are no satisfaction or dissatisfaction, you can say, like the hygiene, the illumination, all those factors, environment. Like, if it is a good environment to work, definitely it's going to be an added advantage for any employee. Or if the hygiene is well and properly maintained, that will be definitely better for everyone. But without that also, people can be retained in an organization provided the satisfaction factors are there. Like the, what are those? Like the achievement, the recognition, if those are done hand to hand and in a proper way, proper evaluation is done and the proper transparency, everything is done, everything is maintained, then there will be satisfaction amongst the employees. So satisfaction, no satisfaction. So other than that, I have also explained the theory X and Y. Y means the good and X means the bad ones. So in that way, it cannot be like, you cannot just define a section of people or anything as bad or good or like that. But anyway, everything has its pros and cons. So after that, we are getting into theory Z. So what is theory Z? Theory Z again is made up of trust, participation and boundaryless organization. So these are the factors, these are the theories that are in content. And what are in process theory of motivation? Equity, expectancy, goal setting. Equity means as in Fayol's 14 principles also we have seen this factor called equity, like maintaining a parity, or because otherwise there will be tremendous amount of grievance if anybody comes to know, like, see, package or everything will definitely won't be same for everybody, that is understandable, but as per their role in the organization or the risk factor or the skills that are involved, that these are the factors, and also their approach and everything matters while defining the package and all. But within the same department or within the same area, if there is too much disparity, then that will be grievance. So, and we don't want that. So so expectancy, what does that mean? So every employees do have some expectations towards their or from their employers. So fulfilling them and analyzing them should be properly practiced. And the last one in the process theory, that is goal setting. So we follow SMART goals. What is SMART? SMART is an abbreviation here, and that is S for specific, M for measurable, A for attainable, R for realistic, and T as in time bounding. So a goal should be something which should be easily achievable and attainable, and it's realistic, it's nothing fancy. So that was the session on motivation, and I have explained content theory and process theory separately. So hope you've liked it, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. And in my next session, there will be the leadership style, and it's all about leadership, as I've mentioned. Keep watching.